Hi, my name is Mae Boburn, and in this video, I'll be talking to you about joint attention. But first, I'd like to start off with a few questions. How do you know what someone is looking at? How do you know someone is looking at what you are looking at? How do you know whether or not a speaker is talking to you and what they are referring to? The answer is joint attention. Joint attention is achieved when one individual alerts another to an object by means of eye gazing, pointing, or other verbal or nonverbal interactions. Joint attention plays a critical role in social and language development. The ability to identify intention is important in a child's ability to learn language and direct attention of others. It's important for many aspects of language development, such as comprehension and acquiring vocabulary words. Some examples of joint attention are looking when your name is called, gaining attention from others, and following auditory directions in a group. One of the concerns is that the ability to establish joint attention may be negatively affected by deafness, blindness, and developmental disorders such as autism. There are three types of joint attention: triadic, dyadic, and shared gaze. Triadic is the highest level of joint attention. It involves two individuals looking at an object. Each individual must understand that the other individual is looking at the same object and realize that there is an element of shared attention. Dyadic is a conversation-like behavior that individuals engage in. This is especially true for adults and infants. Infants engage in this behavior starting at around age 2 months of age. Adults and infants take turns exchanging facial expressions, noises, and in the case of the adult, speech. Shared gaze occurs when two individuals are simply looking at the same object. Shared gaze is the lowest level of joint attention. Individuals who engage in triadic joint attention must understand both gaze and intention to establish a common reference. There's an important distinction between making a request and joint attention. If a child points at something she wants and shifts her gaze to her parent and then back to what she wants, that's a request for the item. If a child points at something not because he wants it, but because he wants to show it to someone else, that would be joint attention. There are two ways an individual engages in joint attention. One is responding to another person's bid for joint attention. For example, an adult points to a picture in a book and says, "Look," the child responds by following the parent's point or gaze and looks at the picture. The second is initiating joint attention. An example of this would be a child looking at a book, pointing to a picture, looking towards the adult and saying, "Hey, look," to get the adult to look too. Joint attention should not be confused with social referencing. Social referencing is characterized by a child looking at an adult to see if the adult is watching what they're doing. It's important to teach joint attention to develop social-emotional reciprocity like conversation, nonverbal communication skills used for social interactions like eye contact, developing, maintaining, and understanding social relationships. This is an important body of research because through behavior analysis, practitioners can teach joint attention responses in children with autism, which may lead to an increased social communication skills and shared responses. Thanks so much for watching. To disseminate the science, please share this video and follow us on our YouTube channel. Bye.